Report: Important conservative columnist strikes back at YouTube for political gag. We need to support him. We all know that huge tech firms at Silicon Valley are infested with left-wing elites. A recent Project Veritas bombshell exposed a dirty relationship between liberal-rag New York Times and the executives of YouTube. We've also seen Google, who owns YouTube, fire their conservative employees, and we've seen YouTube wage a full-scale purge against conservative video channels, demonetizing them and outright banning their content based on dubious allegations. But now they've gone too far. This one takes the cake. According to a WND report, Dennis Prager, a conservative columnist and CEO of the online company Prageru, is filing a lawsuit against YouTube for putting a political gag mechanism on its video content. Prager University describes itself as a conservative nonprofit digital media organization that is associated with and presents the views of leading conservative experts on current and historical events. These videos are an extremely important voice in the Patriot movement, as they are based solidly on Judeo-Christian conservative values, according to Liberty Counsel, who is filing the lawsuit on Prager University's behalf. In the eyes of the liberal tech elites, Prageru's videos apparently aren't safe for children. The suit alleges that the tech giant isn't using its restricted mode to protect young viewers from offensive or inappropriate content, but to stifle content with views that oppose left-wing ideology. Lots of liberals are pointing and laughing at Prager right now. They're saying the Constitution he claims to defend, which gives a private corporation the right to censor whomever they please, is ironically working against him. Not so fast. This is what you can tell your liberal friends. YouTube, Facebook, and these other tech giants are so big, they have a total monopoly on digital communications, just like a public entity. That means, if these firms play the same role as public services and get the same subsidies, then they need to respect the same rights as any part of the government, including a right to speech and expression. Here's a solution. Congress needs to declare a de facto classification for big media companies like YouTube and Facebook as public entities. Considering their dominance in the communication industry and the fact that almost everyone uses them, not to mention that Google is the top tech company that receives the most government subsidies, it should be all but assumed that these big media corporations are only private in name. Even if you want to get a job, many times you've got to have an account on a social media website. That's why the First and Fourth Amendments need be extended for Prager and other conservative voices across the internet. The worth of these massive firms like YouTube extends far beyond just their own interests. Thousands of businesses and individuals are relying on communications to hold up our economy. If YouTube can't get its algorithms straight and quit censoring out unorthodox political opinions, it can literally hurt America's economy. According to Liberty Counsel, YouTube has blatantly admitted that they haven't just accidentally tuned out Prager University out of algorithm flukes, they're actively attacking their channel based on their political views and identity. That's completely unconstitutional. The corrupt tech firm should face the full force of the law and return Prager's First Amendment rights immediately.